Hello everyone and welcome to NewsClick. Today we have with us Dr. S. Kashi, General Secretary of Doctors Forum for People's Health, to discuss about the issues the Tamil Nadu public health sector is facing. Welcome, sir. Tamil Nadu has slipped 6 places down in the health index report published by NITI Aayog. So, what is the reality?
That is the reality. And previous years, usually the Kerala and Tamil Nadu go hand in hand, and first or second places usually occupied by Kerala and Tamil Nadu in the past decade. For the past 5 or 6 years, we are seeing this decline. And last years, in 2015-16, it has slipped to third position. And now it has slipped to 6 positions down, and it has reached the ninth position. There's some discrepancy and interpretation problem that's claimed by the state health authorities. Even then, that is common for all. It cannot be peculiar to Tamil Nadu alone. And what they say, if they calculate the infant mortality rate, for example, that means infant mortality rate means the rate of number of children dies. Number of newborns, the infants die in out of 1,000 labors. So they have taken the denominator as the expected numbers, with the accepted numbers. What the Tamil Nadu government officials says, the actual numbers they have ignored. That is a discrepancy. We are not going to, no need to go into the detail. That is not 100% correct. And since the Tamil Nadu and Kerala have reached highest position, and maintaining that position itself needs a lot of struggle or strength or good initiatives. And two or three things they have pointed out, NITI Aayog report has pointed out, and which tells very clearly that in the past 5 or 6 years, or we can say up to one decade also, we can say for the past 5 or 6 years, it is more acute. For example, the immunization coverage, the problem with immunization is already we have reached we are close to 100% some 5 or 6 years back, and the government was not honest in publishing if anything vaccine related incidents happen. All vaccines can give some adverse reactions, but the government should be honest and can be trustworthy to give the correct figures of complications or adverse reactions, and they should go to the people and explain it. It's not abnormal, it's everything, no need to panic like that. And the classically, I can quote two examples. In 2008 or 2009, in Tiruvallur, there was 3 deaths out of measles vaccination. Even till now, the actual cause of death or actual the offenders of that incident, they have not booked, they have not brought to limelight. And what actually happened, that's also not given by the government. And also compensation also not given adequately. So this was opaque, this one. And another incident, 2016, by February or March, they have conducted the school camps with for MR vaccination. That is measles and rubella vaccination. It's one of the 5 states. Tamil Nadu was the one of the 5 states which implemented the pilot project of the central government health department. But even then, there was no, they were not created any public awareness about that vaccination, need for that vaccination, why we are giving like that. Just like that, they were started. They asked all the schools to give the vaccination. And lot of criticisms have come in, and also because of this latest WhatsApp and other thing, and all these falsehood informations have spread fully. The government was not in a position to clarify doubts, or they did not do anything properly. That's why they lack, they lost the public trust. That's the reason for fall of it. Another thing, the all these vaccinations are not entered properly. After this, once they sense the vaccination coverage is going down, and after this Tiruvallur incident, they were given a separate, they were given an order. In the primary health centers, the routine thing is every Wednesday, the village health centers will take the quota of their need of supplies, vaccines. They will go to the villages, the sub-center, they will give the vaccination. It was the routine usually, and no major death and all never reported so far. But after this Tiruvallur incidents, what they have revised the strategy. Everybody should bring the child to the primary health center, which may be 5 kilometers, 10 kilometers away from their hamlet, their village. So they have to necessarily, the people have to bring the kids to the primary health center, and the vaccination has to be given in the presence of a doctor. They have revised it. And that's why the coverage was not adequate. So many problems, they may not come on time, they may not come, they could not, the transport facilities, they delay lacking in the villages, and they may be the daily wage coolies. So they have to go for work, no? But for vaccination, they cannot cut one day's work salary or like that. And so it was dropping heavily. And another thing, and the, whatever, even after introduction for 6 years back, they have introduced one vaccine, Pentavac vaccine. That is 5 vaccines in one vaccine. It's a combo vaccine. Before, only 3 in one, that's a DPT vaccination was given. The Pentavac was given in that place. That's a good move only. Even after introduction of this Pentavac vaccine, what has happened? Some problems, some adverse reactions happened, and deaths were also reported, not by the government, by the media and people or some other. So it has the government's duty, the government failed in their duty to clarify or tell the people what was actually happening. They were told the government was coming with the explanation that this is not due to this vaccination, it's something else. Some other reason they have died. Everything is pinned to vaccination like that. The next important thing what they have quoted is, the government is well performing in IMR, that's the infant mortality rate, and MMR also. But the thing is, the underweight babies born out of mothers, unnatal mothers, that is increasing. The percentage is increasing. Actually, it should go down. So that indicates that in the underweight children, the mothers, the rate of underweight babies indicates the chronic malnutrition in the mothers, the pregnant mothers. So it indirectly exposes the problems with the lapses in the antenatal care. Our government is spending a lot, we have to acknowledge that, but spending a lot, but whether it is benefited the targeted community, targeted people, that's the question. Because Muthulakshmi Reddy scheme and all, previously it was 12,000 per pregnancy, now it is increased to 18,000, but they are giving it as a cash, but whether the cash is going to the needed antenatal mother, nobody knows. In the Tasmak era, we were told by some of the gynecologists, the husbands want their wives to produce more babies to get more money from the scheme. They were it's a pathetic situation. So that's why in the year after year they are becoming pregnant. There's no spacing. So it is take the toll on the mother's health. That's the second thing which pulled down the index. And third one is this identification and notification of tuberculosis patients and treatment centers and other things. It is also one of the thing which has pulled down the index. That's also true, because in other states, the public sector is very much limited. Private sector is dismal. In our Tamil Nadu, it is both are relatively well developed. So, but treatment is being taken, but it's not reported correctly. That's why that index has gone down. The fourth and most important one is, which has pulled down the index, is vacancies in primary health centers. That's one of the reasons they have given. So why there is suddenly acute vacancies in primary health centers? In the Tamil Nadu, it was more than nearly 100% some 5 years, 10 years back. Even now in northern states, some of the northeastern states is only up to 60%, 50% like that. But we have reached the more than 98% to 100% one decade back. But even now, there's a drop. Why? There are two reasons. One is they have abolished the service doctors quota in the postgraduate seats. That was the only incentive or only attraction towards government service in nowadays. It's not the salary. What the government salary is, ordinary duty doctor will get from the hospitals, private hospitals. That's not an attractive salary and all. But only attraction was the service doctors quota. 50% of the MD, MS seats were reserved for service postgraduates. Those who are in service, they can they can get the seats very easily. Relatively, they can, for lesser marks, it was reserved for them. That quota after this postgraduate NEET examination, that was abolished. And more so, in super speciality, what has happened for the past 6 years, because of the Supreme Court ruling, all 100% of seats are in the annual India pool. So no reservation for the government doctors. So that's why there's acute vacancies, and also the new pension scheme for the government employees, and also the recruitment also they have changed. In Tamil Nadu particularly, there's a recruitment. Previously it was done through Tamil Nadu Public Service Commission, which is a full-fledged service, and once they become permanent, it's a permanent service like that. Not now. The MRB is taking doctors or staff nurses or all other personnels as a contract worker. So on contract basis, 2 years, 3 years only, they will be sticking to this. And since there is no attraction now, the MRB will find it difficult to get doctors also for the primary health centers. That's why there is acute vacancies. So because of this type of vacancies will arise in the medical colleges also, prevailing medical colleges also. And the government is now itself, even now it struggles to get more faculties in the existing government hospitals. So in the future, in the near future, 5 or 10 years down the line, and our health system, particularly the education, will collapse just like that. That's an indication. That's what the downslide of index is indicating.